Alright, so, it's about from the game of South Carolina Camp back with our video. Before we go any further, we give all praise, honor, and glory to the Heavenly Father, His only begotten Son, Yahweh, Ba'ashim, Yahweh Shai, Ba'ashim, Rakakadash, double honor to our apostles and elders, great millstone of teaching us the truth, according to the Bible, rule well, in peace and blessings, so of elect of the nation of Israel. You know, today, through Spirit, by Ba'ashim, Yahweh Shai, go into a lesson basically how we should sow to the spirit and not to the flesh, you know? And that sowing to the flesh isn't going to profit you doing things of this world, doing things that please your flesh, you know, sitting on the couch all day, watching movies, watching YouTube videos about nothing, you know, basketball videos, Hollywood housewife videos, whatever you're watching, you know, isn't going to profit you. The thing that is going to profit you is, you know, watching brothers' videos, exhortations that other brothers do, you know, getting to the scriptures, reading, you know, studying, you know, and ultimately praying to Yahweh Shema Shai, who you people ignorantly call God and Jesus Christ, you know. You know, with that, I'm jumping right into it. This is St. John 6 and 63. It is the spirit that quickeneth. Yeah, if you look up that word quickeneth, it means to make alive, you know? Because we were all once dead without the scriptures talk about he that wondereth out of the way of understanding shall remain in the congregation of the dead. It also tells you in Revelations, the 11th chapter, that their dead bodies shall lie in the great city. You know, that city being America. You know, why are we dead? Because we were without the wisdom, knowledge, and understanding of the scriptures, you know? St. John 6 and 63 is the spirit that quickeneth. Yes, so the spirit hath quickened us. It has made us alive, you know? Now we have the wisdom, knowledge, and understanding of the scriptures. Now we know who we are as a people. Now we know why we are here on this earth. And it's ultimately to serve Yahweh by Shema Shai. St. John 6 and 63 is the spirit that quickeneth, the flesh profiteth nothing. Yeah, in this truth, you know, this is the Lord, our Lord Yahweh Shai, he has put this thing as a business, you know, and in a business you look to bring back profit. So if you're sown to the flesh, you're not gonna reap any profit in the Lord when he comes back. When he's giving you this talent, this wisdom, this knowledge, understanding, he expects a profit from it. And you're not gonna reap a profit for sowing in the flesh. Once again, this is St. John 6 and 63, that is the spirit that quickens the flesh profit of nothing. Yeah, so the flesh profit of nothing. And if you're not profiting anything, you're stagnant, you're not flowing. The flesh profit of nothing. The words that I speak unto you, they are spirit and they are life. Yes, for the words of this Bible, you know, taking heed to the scriptures, doing what the scriptures have commanded you, doing what Yahweh Shai have commanded us to do in these last days, you know, because we're ultimately at the end. That is what's going to quicken us. That is what's going to lead us to eternal life, you know, which we're all fighting for. This book, Galatians chapter 6. I'm going to start at 7. Galatians 6 and 7. Be not deceived, the Most High is not mocked. For whatsoever a man soweth, that shall he also reap. For he that soweth to the flesh shall of the flesh reap corruption. Yeah, so if you sow into your flesh, you working, and you're only working to please your flesh, you're not working to please the spirit and to please and to do the things that are well pleasing to Yahweh Shema Shai, you're gonna reap corruption. I mean, what your reward for sowing to the flesh is gonna be corruption. Galatians 6:8, and it reads, "But he that soweth to the spirit shall the spirit reap life everlasting." Yeah, so if you're sown to the spirit, if you're doing the will of Yahweh Shema Shai, doing what he's commanded us to do, you're gonna reap life, you know. And that life is ultimately is going to start by us being delivered from these set perils, us being delivered from these coming destructions, and ultimately being Lord's own, be part of the elect, being delivered out of America when these ICBM nuclear missiles destroy this place. And let us not be weary in well-doing, you know, so what we're doing is well-doing. This preaching the word of Yahweh Shema Shai is well pleasing in the eyes of the Heavenly Father. For in due season we shall reap if we faint not. Yeah, so in due season, you know, though the visions tearing, well, truly is not tearing, though all hell hasn't broken out in America, and we not on, and if we part of the elect, we haven't made out into the chariots yet. You know, in due season we shall reap if we faint not, because the scriptures talk about he that endureth unto the end, the same shall be saved, you know. This is 2 Ezra chapter 9 verse 7, and everyone that shall be saved and shall be able, yeah, so scriptures talk about everyone that shall be saved, and what we're working, what, for our salvation, you know, we're working so that we can be saved out of America, so we can be saved in those chariots, which people ignorantly call UFOs, and be joined back with Lord Yahweh Shai. He's going to give us those new bodies in rulership. And everyone that shall be saved and shall be able to escape Jacob's trouble, you know, the time of trouble, a time that's never been on this earth, you know, a time when there's going to be a famine, there's a time where there's going to be cannibalism because of lack of bread, there's going to be martial law troops, and ultimately America is going to be destroyed, there's going to be race riots, you know, the RFID chip, which is the mark of the beast, is going to be implemented and pushed, you know, and ultimately America is going to be destroyed by ICBM nuclear missiles, and shall be able to escape by his works and by faith wherein ye have believed, you know. So you have to believe that, you know, if you're going to receive a reward, if you faint not, if you endure unto the end, Yahweh Shema Shai is going to give you a reward for this, you know? This is 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verse 58, and it reads, therefore, my beloved brethren, you know, and that beloved, you know, King David's name meant beloved, you know? So this scripture right here is talking to the house of David, the elect. Therefore, my beloved, be ye steadfast, unmovable, you know, always abounding in the work of the Lord. Yeah, because if we're working, it's like when you're eating healthy and you're it's like sown to the spirit, you know. Once you start eating those green smoothies, you know, you're on a well balanced diet, you're eating a lot of fruits and vegetables, what, you start reaping the benefits of those things, and what, you want to eat more, you want to eat better, you want to keep continuing with that diet because you see the benefits. Well, that's like the scriptures, you know, you sow to the spirit, you know, the Lord's going to give you the increase, you know, you're going to be on fire, you know. But what if you're going to sow to the flesh, you're not going to be on fire, you're going to be cold. This is 1 Corinthians 15 and 58 again. Therefore, my beloved brethren. Yeah, so Paul's talking to their brethren, the brothers in the faith. This is an exhortation. This scripture right here is an exhortation to the brethren. Being steadfast, unmovable, you know. Trusting in the Lord, having faith in the Lord, not wavering in faith, you know. Not letting your sins weigh you down, you know. Always abounding in the work of the Lord, you know, always abounding. That word abound means to exceed a set number, you know. So you should want to exceed the set number of 3 videos a week, you know. You shouldn't let your I haven't done anything all day, I've been doing nothing. You shouldn't let that hold you back from doing the work of the Lord, you know. Trust in the Lord and know that the Lord's mercies are great, and that the simple fact that the Lord still allows you to call on his name means what? The Lord's having mercy upon you. So use that, use this time of grace to get right with the Heavenly Father and keep doing the work. Always abounding in the work of the Lord, for as much as you know that your labor is not in vain in the Lord. Yeah, because we're going to receive a reward, you know. This is Hebrews 6 and 10, and Lord's willing, this be the last scripture. I'm going to close it out. Hebrews 6 and 10, for the Most High is not unrighteous to forget your work and labor of love. Yeah, you're just putting in work, you know. You might have gone a couple days without putting in work, but what? The Most High is not unrighteous. He's seen the trials and tribulation, the temptations that you overcome, you know. Just do the work. Do what the Heavenly Father commanded you do, and you shall receive reward. But first, what? You gotta sow to the Spirit. You gotta be doing things of the Spirit so you can do those things. I'm gonna get one more scripture after this. This is Hebrews 6 and 10. For the Most High is not unrighteous to forget your work and labor of love. Yeah, this is a labor of love. Yahweh Shai said, if you love me, feed my lambs, which he have showed towards his name, you know. That's why we give all praises to Yahweh Shemel Shai at the beginning of our video, This is the, we're showing praise to the Lord's name. In that ye have ministered to the saints and do minister. Yeah, so we're here to edify the elect of the nation of Israel, you know. This is, let me see. Fuck yeah. Clicked on the wrong one. This is Galatians 5 and 16, and it reads, this I say then, walk in the Spirit, you know, walk in the Spirit, and you shall not fulfill the lust of the flesh. Yeah, there it is. So you walk in the Spirit. That proves right there that the Spirit of Yahweh Shema Shai, because we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities. That means the armor that the Lord has equipped us with, the Spirit, the power, is stronger than the spiritual demon Satan. We're more than conquerors in the name of Yahweh Hashem Shai. Galatians 5 and 16, this I say then, walk in the Spirit, what, do things of the Spirit, watch videos, read, turn on, you know, light incense, pray to Yahweh Hashem Shai, do these things which are well pleasing to Yahweh Hashem Shai, you know, walk in the Spirit, fight the good fight of faith, walk in the Spirit, and ye shall not fulfill the lust of the flesh. Meaning what? Paul said he put his flesh under subjection, you know? I mean, under the rule. Meaning what? The Spirit triumphed over the flesh, you know? But verse 17, for the flesh lusteth against the Spirit, and the Spirit against the flesh. Meaning what? They're at war against each other, you know? But the Spirit is stronger than the flesh. And these are contrary one to another, so that ye cannot do the things ye would. You know, so what, we have to walk in the Spirit so we can do those things which are well pleasing to Yahweh Shema Shai. You know, like I read in Galatians the 6th chapter. You know, walk in the, he that soweth to the Spirit shall reap life everlasting. You know, Lord's willing, this lesson was edifying with that. And give all praise, honor, and glory to the Heavenly Father and His only begotten Son, Yahweh, Ba'ashim, Yahweh Shai, Ba'ashim, Rekar Kodash. Double honor, star apostles, and others, great millstone, teach us the truth according to the Bible, and we're well, and peace and blessings, self-elect of the nation of Israel. Next time we say, Shalom.